On 31st December 2020, President Museveni, in his end-of-year address, reopened the economy fully, including the transport sector. All public service vehicles were allowed to carry passengers to the required capacity with strict adherence to the SOPs, such as all passengers must wear face masks and follow the preventive measures of COVID-19. Walking through downtown Kampala, we observed that most taxis were operating at full capacity of 14 passengers. These, however, have decided to cut the transport fares for most of their metropolitan and upcountry trips. In the bus parks, it was a similar story. Many have resumed full operations.
In each and every bus, our crew staff in the bus have masks, keep SOPs in the buses, but up to the extent of taking who has a vaccination card.
Although the transporters have showed commitment to observe SOPs, this appealed to the Ministry of Health to join hands with them. They say that whereas they have ensured that all drivers, conductors and turnboys are vaccinated, the transporters have no mandate to demand vaccination cards from their passengers.
People are totally poor. They don't have money because all income-generating activities have been on standstill.
The transporters decried the ever-increasing fuel prices, which are making the transport business unviable.
The appeal goes to the government that the cost of fuel is very high. If at all the government can reduce, then also bus companies or transporters reduce their fares. That is when Ugandans shall feel everything going smooth.
Since the advent of COVID-19 in March 2020, the transport sector has been one of the most affected. Although the sector had been allowed to operate at half capacity, players say they have incurred huge losses. Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.